Hello! Danish Ants again. Today is finally the day. I've got my queen. So, I have everything set up, ready. I'm gonna walk you through how I am doing it, and now it's your job to either say, decent job, or, oh, you made this mistake. So, that's why I have this channel, to learn myself and maybe learn you guys something. So without further ado, I'm gonna take you down like this and like so. So she's in here and I'm just gonna gently take it up. So I've got her from anstore.de. And there's a ton of information of different stuff and what I got. And there we go. And store. Yes, very cool, very cool. So let's have a look. I did open to make sure that she was alive, and she very much is. So I got two things. I've got a packet of food mix with all kinds of grain, as they are harvester ants. And for the big prize herself, oh, and she is alive. Just gonna slowly handle her. And there we go. Let me just turn off that light. There we go. There she is. And she is alive. Is, from what I can see, no eggs or anything, but we are just gonna slowly put her into her new world. But for now, we're gonna put her down again and just put this on top of her and take her to the side again. All right, so first things first, we've got this starter thing for her, and all of a sudden this does look very small. So you tell me, is this too small for her? I'm gonna put her tube in this outworld, and then she can come out when she's ready. So I've got some water, and I got the pipette. I'm just gonna suck up some water and fill it in. There we go. Slowly see the sponge gets more wet. I did read that they prefer their chambers to be fairly dry, but we're gonna try this now and see if we do need to let it dry out a bit before moistening it again. Slowly and very clumsy. There we go. I can see when I'm trying to just push water out. Let's see if I can get you a bit closer to the action. Sorry for the handling. All right, so, like so. Okay, there we go. You can slowly, maybe you can see when I am pushing down more water now and forcing it. It bubbles out between the layers. So the sponge is all wet now. Yeah, let's not do it anymore. We also got these protein. We're not gonna do anything with that now. Wipe off the excess water. There we go. And like so. And Before I made the video, I did put on Fluon on the entire outworld. And again, sorry for the movement. So, what I am also thinking is I'm gonna put a bit of sand down here. It's very fine and it is clean, which is the most important thing, right? So I thought this would be a nice way to keep the test tube steady, and when she's ready, when maybe the workers, if they come, they can move it around. All right, like so. Hoping this would be enough, or I will put in some more later. So should I make like a small hill in front of a tube? I'm thinking I'm actually gonna try that. So it won't feel as open for her, because I think they are claustral. I think I read that. So I'm thinking if we put her down like this, there would still be something in front of the hole. Do I put some seeds down? No, I don't think I do that yet. Do I put down a drop of sugar or anything? I think being claustral mean that they come out when they start laying eggs. The temperature in Denmark is not that high, so she will be needing to go into a warm room, which we are warming up at the moment to be around 21, 22 degrees, 20, 23 maybe. So yeah, I think that's it. Let's have a look at her. And she's still doing fine. She has a lot of water. Ooh. So do I even remove this? I don't think I'm gonna remove it yet. Oh, there we go. Alright. I'm actually not gonna open it yet. Oops. Well done. There we go. I think I'm just gonna put her down for the moment. Hold her just gently. Alright. I might be too gentle, but you know, first queen, so and it is red and she's slowly moving down there. Let's see if I can put you a bit closer. I feel all. There we go. Maybe a bit further down. I do have to get used to all this close up. I do some Warhammer unboxing as well, and that is big stuff. So you don't really have to be that close to things. But there she is. Oh, she's moving a bit more around. We opened the box just before, making sure that she was alive. And the only comment my girlfriend made was like, "Oh, that's a big ant." Yeah, if you knew the big ants, it would be crazy. So yeah, finally, I got myself an ant. And there's plenty of water, and there's Messor Barbarus and everything. So do I put some, do I open this now? Please do comment. Do I wait? How long do I wait? I did read up on some of the stuff, but you know, when finally getting a live creature, you want to make sure it's right. Because maybe she's hungry. I don't know. Please do comment, and I'll make another video soon of what I'm going to do next. So for now, excuse my movement with the camera. Just gonna move it a bit more. There we go. Boom. Wow, that's an old guy. Let's get some light on him. So that's my first ant. I'm so excited. Can't stop looking at her. But for now, I'm gonna transport her up to the room, which is upstairs, which is never used. So she's just gonna be there nice and quiet. We're gonna warm it up. And so my questions, well, it's a bit of crooked, isn't it? All right, doesn't matter. So my questions for now, do I open the tube? Do I feed her? Or do I just keep it closed? Comments, ideas, knowledge? I read stuff about the Messors, but again, when getting one real life, it's a living animal. And my faith, tells to respect every living animal. So, yeah. Wow, she is pretty. Anyways, I'm gonna leave you to writing a lot of stuff. Maybe clicking subscribe. Maybe the bell button so you can get updates on new videos. So I'm gonna transport her very gentle upstairs so she can get some warmth. All right. Thank you for now, and I will see you very soon. Bye-bye.